breeding rattlesnakes. We're going to put the big ones together coming up. Yo, Venom Squad. Hey, this is rattlesnake breeding season. So I'm getting ready to move some big animals around, and my wife thought this would be a good idea to video this for you guys. Now, we're in the fall season. This is when I start cooling everything down. I start cooling this room down and breeding neotropical rattlesnakes and the big monster basiliscus. And I'm going to explain it to you, just how we breed them. I mean, it's not a big secret. So I'm going to tell you guys how I do it and just show you the way it's done. It's actually pretty simple. Now, all summer, all spring, all summer, all year, they're maintained at a higher temperature. They get a good basking spot, and they're fed on a pretty good basis. And this time of year, when it's cooling off, I kind of let this main room where I keep a lot of the neotropical rattlesnakes and the basiliscus and that stuff, I let it kind of cool off also. I mean, this room's already down into, it's already down to 75 degrees, okay? And breeding, this is when it starts happening. September is when it starts happening. October, November, those 3 months are when a lot of these neotropical rattlesnakes will start chasing each other just from the slight change in temperature. That's when they're going to start getting active. But I still cool them a little bit. Temperatures have dropped in here about 15 to 20 degrees from the summertime temperatures. So that's what cues it. That's what turns them males on to start chasing them females. So I've already got one pair of basiliscus that have already copulated. One have already bred. They're already done. But I'm still going to put another female, our second female, in with this big male so she gets bred also. But what I'll do is after she's bred, I'll split them back up. The females will go into one enclosure, and then the male will stay by himself until next breeding season. But I'm going to let this room get down until about the 60s, and I'm going to leave it there for the rest of the winter. But I'll still give my neotropical rattlesnakes a little hot spot if they choose to go get on it. They're not like our native rattlesnakes here where they need a long, hard brumation. I've never done it with neotropicals where I've knocked them down for 3 months and kept them really cold and in the dark. I just kind of let them cool down a little bit, raise the humidity a little bit, still give them a little warm spot if they choose to get on it, and they just do it naturally. That's what works for me. That's how I've been doing it for years, and that's what works for all the neotropical stuff and the basiliscus, the Mexican West Coast rattlesnake. Now, what I do is most people would stop feeding rattlesnakes during this process. I don't. I still feed them. If they'll eat, I feed them. And most people would be like, well, that's not right because the food's going to sit in their stomach and it's going to blow up and get putrid and rot. Well, they're not at that cool of a temperature. They can actually take them lower 60s, but they got a hot spot. So they still get fed. Just not as often. And I've been getting babies year after year after year. So it works. And I believe feeding them is keeping that mama strong. And she's feeding them babies. It's fuel to the fire. So it's what works for me. It might work differently for somebody else, but this is the way I've been doing it. I'm not the world authority on breeding rattlesnakes, but I've been doing these for many years. And that's all it requires. Just let them cool down naturally and keep them going. But we've already had one successful breeding, and now we're going to move all these big rascals around and pair them up. Another pair is going to get put together. So I'm going to pull this big female out and put her on here. Now, I had to clean this cage out. I just had to extract the shed skin. Oh, that's important too. Usually, I'll put males and females together this time of the year. I'll wait for the female to shed her skin. And I'll take that shed skin and throw it in the cage with the male. And then I'll put the female in. It does something to them. It's like it's like perfume for them. It's funk of snake olay. I mean, they love it. I've had males actually smell them shed skins from the females, the pheromones coming off of it, and head bob it. And it's really cool to watch. And I'll give them a day just with that shed skin. It's getting them revved up and ready to go. And then I'll put the female in. And I usually get copulation right away. So it's just a little trick I do. And I just kind of thought not big on free handling. I don't believe in it. But when you're moving snakes of this size, I mean, these guys are this big around, and they're six-footers. They're just big rattlesnakes. You got to put your hands on them. There's just no two-way around it. It's just literally you got to be able to support them and move them. And it's not free handling. I'm still using my hook, but you got to be able to move them and support them. And they're just so monstrous, you got to be comfortable enough to lift them and be comfortable doing it. So you're going to get to see me do this, guys. And I ain't going to lie, it's scary. Because if one of these big bastards bit me, I'd be in a world of trouble. Yeah, I've got anti-venom, we got a bite protocol, all that, but who wants to go through that shit, right? But anyways, I'm going to move this big girl out of here, and we're going to get started. Okay, we're going to get this big girl out of here, and she's a problem because she's up high. And that's why I leave the big male on the bottom, because he's too difficult to lift up and get into a cage that's up high. So, but she's big enough where she's a problem. So this isn't easy to do, to get her big ass out of here. But what I normally got to do is remove the high box. And she's a pretty big rattlesnake. She's a big girl. We're going to let her go right. Sometimes it doesn't go the way it's your plan. You just stay calm and stay on mission, because as soon as you lose your cool is when you end up getting bit. Anytime you're working with an animal, it's not going to go the way you plan. So you got to be ready to do something different at the drop of a hat. So, all right, now she's crawling right in the box, and that's great. That's exactly what I wanted to do, because I don't want her to accidentally bite the male when I put him in there, because she will. If she's in an excited state right now, she's rattling, she's scared, she's nervous. If I throw that male right in there on top of her, she may just light him up. So I'm going to let her go in that high box and then put him in on the other side, so they don't have the opportunity to bite each other. Let's let them get to know that they're each in there. They'll smell each other once they're in there together, and then it'll be fine. Okay, now that we got her moved, we're going to put the other female that I just extracted from this bottom cage into this top cage, because she needs to be on her own now. And I'm going to keep feeding her, even though I'm cooling these animals down, even though I'm letting them get into the 60s for the next few months, but she's still got her hot spot. And I'm still going to give her medium rats. But you got to understand something. I'm not giving her big jumbo rats once a week. She still gets her medium rat maybe every 3 to 4 weeks. So she may eat 2 to 3 times over this period. And it's not a true knockdown hibernation cold. With neotropical rattlesnakes, all they really require is a cool down. Now the cool down, literally, this room will get into the low 60s at night. I do it with the whole room. Even with some of my baboons, I let them go through the same cycle. And then, literally, back during the day when it's warming up outside, this room will get up maybe 75. It'll get a little warmer, but that's what it's going to do all winter. And that's all it needs to trigger a breeding response in the tropical rattlesnakes. It works good with the Mexican rattlesnakes, anything Central South American. And they don't require that long knockdown like our North American rattlesnakes will go through. They don't really require that long brumation. But I'm going to throw her big butt in here, and I've got her in a can. All right, big girl. Come on, sweetie. beast, the big boy. And he's not easy to move because he's so damn heavy. But that's why we keep him low. It's much easier to move him low than it is lifting him up here. It takes two people to lift him up here on a hook anyways. I don't know what he weighs. I haven't weighed him in quite a bit, but I'm suspecting he's got to be at least 20 pounds if he's not a pound, because he's a monster. All right, let me get some of this stuff out of the way. Okay, now we're going to move this big male into here. Now the female's already in there. She's already tucked up in the big hive. It's safe to slide him in there. Now, he's a beast, so I may have to set him on the floor, reposition him a few times. Don't be afraid to reposition. That's just key. You don't have to keep the snake on a hook all the time. As long as you got control of him and there's nobody else in the immediate area. Like, literally, I've got my wife. She's up on a ladder right now. She's standing 6 feet behind me with the camera up on a ladder in case the snake slides over that way, just to keep everybody safe. But let's get him out. What's up, big dog? All right. Now, you notice I switched hooks. But this snake's weight requires this big, flat hook. See it, sometimes you do. Like I caught the other pair, this male and this other female copulating a few weeks back. Now they would take a picture of it real quick. But a lot of times it happens and you don't know it happened. And rattlesnakes, everything, I mean, they just take so damn long. And I'm going to tell you, gestation, for a lot of these neotropical rattlesnakes, it's 8 to 9 months. They're going to breed this year, this fall, this winter. They're not going to have the babies till next year. It just, you don't think it's never going to happen, and all of a sudden you walk in and there are babies everywhere. But the trick is just light cycle. They're getting the ambient room light. They're getting that photo period. But it's just letting the temperatures drop for just a little while. Just for the fall. That cues them to go. It works great with any tropical stuff. Okay, we got everybody together that I want together. We got the big female with the big male. We'll let him have a honeymoon with her for a little bit. And hopefully 9 months from now, we'll be filming baby basiliscus in these exhibits. So mark the date. It'll be about 9 months. That's usually where the basiliscus run. But we've already got all our other stuff paired up, all our neotropical stuff, the dryanus, the Cuminensis, the Zobcons are going again, but it's that simple to breed neotropical stuff. The rattlesnakes are pretty easy to do. There's not no big secret to it. It's just knowing the cues, knowing when to put them together. A lot of times, I can tell when the male is starting to get into that mode because he'll stop eating, and he'll constantly cruise the cage. He'll be nosing everything. And it's because he's looking for a female. Just the drop in temperature and the little bit of rising humidity, it cues them. y'all like this. Just a quick little video. Just moving some snakes around. I wanted to tell you just how easy it is to breed any tropical stuff. And don't forget to like, hit the notification, hit the little V, hit my little symbol down there. If you're new to the channel, hit that, and that'll get you to subscribe. That's how you subscribe. Hit that, our logo, okay? It's been a long day. I'm tired. I'm filthy. I've been working in the snake room all day. But if you're new, please subscribe and give us a thumbs up and come on back to Venom Central. We got a lot of other stuff coming. Everybody have a good day, and I hope you had a nice Thanksgiving. And Willie.